you will never see me asking this question.
This is why we're polite with you.
You know, because I know in Bible does claim Jesus claimed to be God according to Bible, and I'm not saying.
Are you saying he doesn't say it in the Quran as opposed to the Hadith?
You're playing with my words again. I say nowhere Allah says in the Quran. Tafsir is the word of a mufassir, of a man.
Ibn Kathir saying, "End of everything, we are the All Knower to tell the story
for
Allah."
So is he quoting Allah? He's quoting Allah.
He's quoting Allah. So he's speaking on behalf of Allah.
Can I say? There's a conflicting hadith of the same story.
Thank you. So now he's showing us more contradictions in the Islamic narrative.
Question.
No, I don't deal with the DCCI.
I'm not DCCI.
Okay.
I'm an independent evangelist.
I was just making my way to pray. Awesome.
You're making way to
but
pray.
But I'll be back later.
You can join us.
I want to pray to the devil, unfortunately.
You want to pray to the God of Jesus?
No, you don't pray to the God of Jesus.
Let's debate that.
You wouldn't call
God
Jesus.
Let's debate that.
John 7:3.
Let's debate that. Okay, let's debate that. After, hey, can we debate that?
Okay. Let me go pray for. Let me pray to the God of Jesus.
No, no, you're not praying.
You're praying to Satan.
Allah is Satan. You're praying to Satan.
Allah is Satan, my friend.
You're a God of the world.
He's the one. That's true. Yeah. Yeah, so he's Allah. They're going on the world.
They're going to pray.
Yeah. No, but we're going to debate on that though.
You're not praying.
When you come back, we're going to debate you, bro. Jesus.
Abbas.
Have you filmed Abbas today? He's a joke now.
I like the rejection.
You've always been a gentleman, but we've got to ask you to stop calling the Christian preacher. I'm not going to take my words back.
Okay.
Are you learning anything?
That's a good question.
Are you learning anything from
Christian? I'm learning about him.
Can I ask you a question?
I'm learning how weak his arguments are.
Why do you say his arguments are weak when he's consistently shown you that what you're worshipping is wrong?
Can we
that your doctrine
can
is wrong.
I do a salah, pray?
Let me pray.
And after prayer, let's address his strongest point, and I will address it. Because he cut me off, he won't let us speak, he talked over.
I can never really address his accusation.
So let's bring
his. I will not say let's address his accusations. Let's address what you're learning from him. Let's get this positive.
Okay.
Because we have our independent thought. We've heard the narrative. So let's get what you're learning. What is it doing to help your polemics
and
or your apologetics or whatever?
As a Muslim, I'm learning from anywhere. Wherever I find right thing, I learn. Yes? So sometimes, you know, there's somebody ask a very holy person, you have a very good manners. Where you learn your good manners from? You know what he says? I learn my good manners from the ill-mannered. When I see the ill-mannered, the way he behaves, I say I'm going to do the opposite of what he's doing. So I am learning something from him.
Okay.
And what he bring the questions, good questions, and I go back study and I learn my Islam.
And
I know his implications are wrong.
I would disagree with you there.
I think what he's saying is generally not making sense to you.
At least you got a few little sound bites. I still think Abbas is deluded. The Bible does talk about the great delusion. When you're arguing with Christian Prince and he's consistently making your narrative wrong, I think you need to address the argument questions rather than looking for loopholes. So I still think Abbas is wrong, but let's hear what he has to say.
I think he's a very sincere man. And I really appreciate his sincerity for his faith, and which is beautiful. And that's why those Christians I see sincere, I know they love their God. They're sincere to the God.
You two actually get on. You just want to get on.
Blocking me.
Yeah, that's because
he keeps blocking you because he gets frustrated.
As you can see, that's because he showed you something like he showed you this, and you say, "I can't see it." That's what it is. That's why
my brother said a beautiful thing. He said, "I frustrate him."
Yeah.
Yes, you do.
And do you know that? Do you know truth frustrates lie?
Abbas, the Bible tells us the nature about of the great truth. Delusion.
The nature of truth is to frustrate all the lies.
Which you very know. He meant you frustrating because you're literally...
But the truth
he literally shows you this and you say, I can't see it.
Let's get to the crux of the matter, Abbas. All the time you call into the Christian Prince show, you're challenging him on Islamic arguments without understanding the Arabic behind it. Now, Christian Prince knows the Arabic and he's revealing all these theological arguments to you. And you're seeing them on display. I don't know whether you're always driving, as he says. Because
that's not true.
Well, the point is
I call him so many times, maybe four or five times I'm driving. And you remember that.
You can see the clear translations, but you still refuse to see the truth.
Okay, okay.
That is what I'm really... What is the crux? Why are you putting a mental block?
Okay.
You're an intelligent man. I like you here. Yeah. And this is why we came to speak with you. Because you've always been respectful. You've always been polite. I see you as intellectual.
I follow the example of my
your brain. Sorry. You're not following your brain.
Yes, I am.
You're a bit higher than that.
What I know him.
You're more intellectual.
What I know him is this is a biography. What I know him as a person, I follow his example. So I can answer your question that he knows Arabic. So why I'm arguing with him, he knows Arabic. Do you know this is the argument Christians use against those Muslims like Muhammad Hijab and Shamsi. When they say, do you know Arabic? What the Christians say? Ah, hiding behind Arabic. What is kind of a Muslim hiding behind Arabic? But they say, you don't know Arabic, so we're telling you to learn from us, but you refuse. He said, no. Same thing when I talk to CP, I believe what he's presenting in Arabic, he's deceiving in that Arabic somehow.
But how do you know he's deceiving?
I'm going to give you an example. Example is the last time, chapter 2, verse 177, I brought to him about.
277.
Chapter 2, verse 77, he says, free the slaves, yeah? The word used there is rikab. I didn't know what it means, rikab, because we know slave means abd. Abdul means slave. Like, you know, he always call Abdul people,
Abdul is slave of Allah. That's different.
But Abdul is slave. Abdul means slave. Abdullah means slave of Allah.
Right.
Yeah. So I say, look, free slave. He say, where's the slave word there? Word slave is not there. And it's true. Abdul is not there. But the word there is in the cup. And I didn't know at that time. I was completely taken aback because the word rikab. Now he didn't tell us what rikab means. And I said, I promise you, I'm going to come back to you tomorrow. Yeah, since my limited language, limited in Arabic, I'll come back. So I came back to him. And you know what I learned about the word rikab? Rikab means a servant or a slave who's seeking to be free. Seeking to be free. That's what it means. So the verse says, spend your money on the orphans, on the wayfarers, and on rikab. So in a nutshell, that is actually telling you to free the slave, those who are seeking to be free. But he played with it, the word.
Well, he didn't really play because he told you about Bilal that wasn't actually freed by Muhammad. So it goes in a contradiction against what the Prophet...
No, you're not getting my point. You understand what I'm saying?
I'm understanding your point,
Bilal
but I'm not agreeing with your
but
point.
But what I'm saying, that verse is telling us to spend money on rikab, those people who are seeking to be free.
And what are you saying CP said that verse means? You're saying CP said it means something different?
CP say it does not say free the slave.
Right.
But, okay, the word, he said, okay, where's the word free? Okay, fair enough, word free is not there. But the rikab is actually telling you to spend the money on rikab, meaning spend the money of people who want to be free. So CP was playing with Arabic there, and I caught him, what happened there? Result?
Did you put that to him?
Yeah.
And what did he
what
say?
The result is?
What was
I'm
the
banned, I'm blocked. He put the phone down on me, he blocked me.
I disagree, but one of the things I do agree with is one of the statements you made. You said there's a clear contradiction in the Quran, and this was the first thing that we went on to. Now, he told you about one part of the Quran says you can marry Christian women, and one part of the Quran says you cannot marry polytheists. And you said there was a contradiction in the Quran. These are words because we made a video, we're the first ones to spot this, and we made up questions.
And what did I say to you when I met you? What did I say to you?
I would like you to say your own words.
Okay. Yes. What I said, he says, look, in the Quran, one part it says, chapter 5, verse 5, that you can marry the Christians and Jews, the Ahle Kitab, you can marry. And then he said, if I show you, then the other part it says you cannot marry. I say, that is a contradiction.
No, you said it's a clear contradiction.
No.
I remember your words very clearly.
No.
I have it on my phone.
I
do my research, okay, brother.
Let me make my point. I say, that is a contradiction. But what happened then? I said, can you prove it to me where it is? And what? And then CP understood exactly what I said. And you know what he says? Let me prove it to you. if he knows that I say that I agreed with it, contradiction, he said, look people, what he says. Now let me prove it to him. Then when he bring that verse back, and I say that is not about Ahl-e Kitab. That is talking about Mushrikeen. Mushrikeen, Allah says in the Quran, Allah never called Ahl-e Kitab, Jews and Christians, never called them Mushrikeen.
Yes, he does. We're called polytheists in Tafsir. No. I have the Tafsir. We've done this.
It's not talking about the Quran.
No. We're talking about the Tafsir in Kathir.
Tafsir is actually Christians
and Jews are called Mushrikeen. Listen. And we're called polytheists. That is what the Tafsir.
Are you saying he doesn't say it in the Quran as opposed to the Hadith?
You're playing with my words again. I say nowhere Allah says in the Quran. Tafsir is the word of a Mufassir, of a man. His understanding. I say nowhere in the Quran, like Allah. Yeah, tafsir nowhere in the Quran. Word. Yes. Nowhere in the Quran Allah addressed Jews. I'm
a free, take another beating from Hatton.
Yeah, I know. I'm a punching bag. You know why not? Yeah? So nowhere Allah when Allah say Jews and Christians, call them address them Ahl-e Kitab. Allah did not address them as Mushrikun. Allah addressed Mushrikun are the other pagans, polytheists. So that's why I was telling CP. That's not a contradiction. That verse is for Mushrikun. You cannot marry Mushrikun, but you can marry Ahl-e Kitab. So that's not a contradiction.
So you're saying
never
that the Tafsir is not the word of Allah.
Tafsir is not a word of Allah. That's okay. The understanding.
So
and
we have
the Tafsir is not the word of Allah.
I like Abbas.
Tafsir is the mind of a man. The scholars, they are writing their understanding. And do you know that there are Tafsir? They disagree with each other.
Okay. So can I?
So it is the word of Allah. Why one scholar is disagreeing with the other?
We have to disagree with you because if we look at Surah 34:12.
Right.
And we look at the Tafsir by Ibn Kathir. And to Solomon, we subjected the wind. Its morning journey was that of a month, and its afternoon journey was that of a month. And we made flow for him spring of liquid copper. And among the jinn were those who worked for him with permission of the Lord. And whoever deviated from our command, we will make him taste the punishment of the blaze. So this is the Tafsir. And the we is Allah speaking. So now you said that the Tafsir.
Yeah?
Yes, this
so
is
Tafsir. You're reading the words, direct words you're reading. 34:12.
I like this.
Let me just read.
Having mentioned the blessings that Allah follows this mentioning, he gave to Dawood's son Suleiman, Solomon, may peace be upon them. He subjected the wind to him so that it will carry his carpet one way for a month and back again for next month. Al-Hasan Bukhari said, he set up.
I'm confused. This is the verse and this is the Tafsir.
Yes.
So you read the verse first, but you said this is the Tafsir.
No, that's
this
the
is not the, yeah, this is the verse.
This
that's
is the verse.
About.
One second, yes. One second.
So what's wrong with that verse?
No, because you're saying that the Tafsir do not have the word of Allah.
I didn't say that. He say is the Tafsir is the word of Allah. You say is the Tafsir is the word of Allah. You're talking about as a whole. No, but of course in the Tafsir there's the verses of the Quran. But I'm talking about as a whole. Meaning the Mufassir can make mistakes. In the Tafsir there can be errors. So we cannot take Tafsir as a whole as a word of God. For us, Quran is a word of God. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? So yeah, Tafsir as a whole, you can't say as it's a word of God.
How can you say the Tafsir is not the word of God when it has quotes from
Tafsir
Allah?
Tafsir is the explanation and the understanding of a scholar of the words of God, or the words of the Quran. So in that understanding, as a human work, they can make errors. And we no Muslim ever say the complete Tafsir is the word of God, and we take every word of the Tafsir.
Okay.
No Muslim say that. If they say that, I'll challenge them.
So let me read the Tafsir by Ibn Kathir, because he said that the Tafsir does not have Allah's words. So,
I didn't say that. You
okay,
play
okay.
I just said, I said Tafsir is not the word of Allah.
Okay, the Tafsir is not the word of Allah.
That's the difference here.
Tafsir does not have
the word of Allah.
So, you know, I gave an example before and it wasn't accurate. And of everything, we are the all-knower. This is the Tafsir Ibn Kathir, verse 21:81 of the Quran. And I'll start again. And of everything, we are the all-knower. He had a mat made of wood on which he would place all the equipment of his kingship, horses, camels, tents, and troops. Then he would command the wind to carry it, and he would go underneath it, and it would carry him aloft, shading him and protecting him from the heat, until it reached wherever he wanted to go to the land, in the land. Then it would come down and deposit his equipment and entourage. Allah says,
Hadouken!
So Abbas is wrong. That is the point I'm making. You said the Tafsir does not have Allah's word. It's all clear, and we the all know. So who is this? Is this Ibn Kathir or Allah's word?
Can I say something?
Yeah, go ahead.
So in the end, he said Allah says, yeah?
Yeah, it says Allah says, right?
All the above.
And of everything, we are the all know. We, who is the we? That is Allah. That is the royal we. Brother, you can't look. You can't touch this. I'm not Christian Prince.
You are not Christian Prince, of course not. But listen, who is challenging this? They say we are all nowhere. Who's saying this is not a word of Allah? Who say this is not a word of Allah? We are the all knower. No Muslim says this is not a word of Allah.
Yeah, but that's the
tafsir. But when you say,
that's the tafsir. They said no tafsir is a word of Allah. That's what you said.
You didn't say that.
That's not a contradiction.
So you're saying that the tafsir is not the word of Allah.
Tafsir is not a word of Allah.
You did.
It's on camera.
You got the word of Allah.
You know, it's
cognitive dissonance.
Let me say something. If you say that this is biography of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, if you say this is the word of Allah, I would say no. But if you say, is there a word of Allah is in it? I say yes, because it's called word of Allah. But as a whole, it's not. So same thing here, when you read it, carpet, camels, shading, and everything, and then Allah says, I say Allah did not say this.
No, it says
things.
Allah says, and it says, and of everything, we are the all-knower.
No, no.
That's Allah.
No.
Are you saying it's not?
No. Kathir saying that.
No. It says, brother. And of everything, we are the all-knower. So even Kathir is speaking for Allah's behalf, are you saying that? Because Shamsi had a very big confliction with this flying carpet. He was denying it. But I said it was Allah's words. Okay. So this is...
Okay. Can we establish what you're saying?
No. Let's say for the sake of argument. You say Ibn Kathir says that this is the word of Allah. Yeah, Ibn Kathir. Yeah.
No.
Now I'm asking you, Quran, Allah says they're carrying horses, camels, tents, and troops, and carry. Show me where it is in the Quran.
Okay, so Surah 21:28. And Solomon, we subject to the wind, blowing forcefully, proceed on a command to the land we are blessed, forever all things knowing. All right. So the past Solomon is on par. Then the tafsir.
This is the Quran, yeah? And this is the Quran.
Yeah, that's the Quran. Okay.
Quran is to Muslims is the word of Allah, yes?
Yeah.
All know that. Now, where in that Quranic words Allah mentioned the horses, the camels, the tents, and the...
Now we're going to the tafsir. Now read it again.
So
hold on. Don't try the mental gymnastics. No. It's not working. You're digging a hole.
I think I'm trying to be very honest.
You're not being honest.
You're just doing semantics here.
No, it's not semantics.
That doesn't work with me.
Look at this. And I'm of everything, we are the all knower. It's not that. Who's the we?
I think you're misunderstanding me.
No. Answer. Can I answer the way I want to answer?
When Ibn Kathir start his interpretation, tafsir, he's starting with the word of Allah.
Oh, so he's speaking on Allah's behalf then?
No, he's writing what Allah says.
He's quoting Allah.
He's quoting Allah.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So what I'm saying is, tafsir as a whole is not a word of Allah, meaning there can be errors in tafsir because that's a human word. For example, if we say tents and horses and all that, I will ask Ibn Kathir, if you are Ibn Kathir. Sheikh Ibn Kathir, tell me, where did you learn that there are tents and horses in that cart?
Okay.
What did he say?
So I'll challenge him. Can I challenge your association?
Unless he say, okay, I'll show you the hadith. If he bring the hadith, then I say, fair enough. Mutawatir hadith. But if he doesn't bring any proof through Quran and hadith, then I challenge him, where do you get this from?
If you read the first line, it's very obvious that Allah is speaking. Yeah. Because it says, of everything...
Can I ask you, who's speaking here? Can I ask you, Abbas, who's saying this?
Just read the first line.
That's the first line.
Just
read it out.
Ibn Kathir says, and of everything, we are the all-knower.
So Ibn Kathir, you're saying is speaking this, okay?
Yeah. Okay. And then he says, he had a mat made of wood on which he would place all the equipment of his kinship, horses, camels, tents, troops, and everything. Okay. Let's say you are saying Ibn Kathir is telling us that Allah is telling us everything.
So Ibn Kathir,
and of everything, we are the all-knower. Ibn Kathir is saying, and of everything, we are the all-knower to tell the story
for
Allah.
So is he quoting Allah? He's quoting Allah.
He's quoting Allah. So he's speaking on behalf of Allah.
Can I say? I hope you are sincere people.
I'm being very sincere. I know Allah speaking.
Now the question is, you know the basic of Islam. The Quran came to who?
Muhammad.
Not Abu Bakr, not Usman, not anybody. We all believe that Muslims believe that. Rightly or wrongly. We know the Quran didn't come to Ibn Kathir.
Yeah.
Allah didn't reveal to him.
No.
So my question to Ibn Kathir is, where did you learn that Allah is saying this to you? How do you know? Muhammad didn't tell us. Nowhere in the hadith. nowhere in the Quran. So where
So now we can see Abbas is throwing one of the big six scholars of Islam, of Sunni Islam,
out of the ground.
So once again,
so once again,
is a contradiction.
That's a massive scholar.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying to you.
One of the six.
Now I just want to be clear.
Canonized documents of Islam.
I want to see it completely clear. Are you throwing it away?
No. I'm not throwing it completely away. Of course not. What I'm saying is, there are things Mufassir can say that we Muslims can challenge. Because for me as a Muslim, my first criteria is the Quran.
Okay.
Yeah. Second criteria is the Sunnah of the Prophet. Uh-huh. It's common sense.
Yeah.
Third criteria is the very mutawatir hadith. Hadith which is mentioned again and again by many. Then tafsir comes after. So if tafsir goes against the Quran, against the hadith, then I can challenge. If this is ambiguous, neither going against the Quran, neither with
Abbas,
the Quran, then we can take it or leave it.
Abbas, you're a nice guy, but I'm going to have to take this back round.
Right.
Now, sorry, you're being disingenuous. So
okay.
I would have to say
I heard that before.
I have to,
many times.
And of everything, we are the all-knower. He made a mat.
Yeah.
That is very, very concise. That's Allah's words. But one thing you have done is clarify that Ibn Kathir, one of the six canonized books of Islam, is not good with reputation. So you have put your religion under the
I didn't
the
say that.
Well,
I say that I do not take everything Ibn Kathir says as a word of God.
Okay.
No. So I am allowed to challenge. So no matter how big the scholar is a human being.
Okay.
They are not inspired by God, so they can make error and they cannot. You know, Abu Hanifa, he himself says that if any of my word goes against the hadith, throw my word on the wall. He himself says that. And even Imam Malik says that one person you cannot disagree with, that is Muhammad.
All right.
Every other human being can disagree, and that's the scholar saying that.
Abbas, you have a lot of things to say, but we just asked, and it's only seven words. Mm. And of everything, we are the all-knower. So who is this we that is speaking?
According to Ibn Kathir, that's Allah.
Okay, according to Ibn Kathir.
Yeah.
You disagree with Allah?
No, I'm not saying that. I have to admit. Okay. Look, so, in the Quran probably says that Allah.
Now,
and
Abbas,
we know Allah is the all-knower.
We've taken a long route to just clarify one paragraph of a tafsir. Now,
well, I think you misunderstood. I'm keeping repeating the same
thing.
I
don't misunderstand. What I'm trying to do is those so-called films, you're getting a little cult following. A lot of guys think you're coming to Christ. And a lot of...
I am always with Christ.
I'm always with Christ.
And I want you to be with the Christ that I know.
Christ
is my brother. He's my brother. In my faith, he's my brother.
You got a cult following.
Same way all the lovers of our brothers in faith.
You're a nice guy. And I clarify. I'll buy your coffee anytime.
Don't be fooled by my smile, really.
No, we're not.
Inside, that's what we're trying to show. So we're trying to show your cult fans. This guy does not want Christ in his life.
He does not want salvation.
This is the guy that is misguided with the wrong doctrine of Islam.
Don't.
Antichrist.
I am
going to
pull you. I'm
going to
pull you out from the, I would say, darkness into
out of
light.
Darkness
Islam.
Into light.
I am a zealot.
He's a zealot. So you heard it from your mouth. Those of you that are hero worshiping
That's right. Don't
saying
be fooled.
He's going to be a
don't,
don't.
Don't.
Don't be fooled.
Don't.
This is the Antichrist spirit.
I'm going
to. You need to be aware.
Don't be fooled.
He said it. Don't be fooled.
I didn't say Antichrist. I didn't say Antichrist.
You just talk about your faith.
I say I want to bring the Christian brothers and sisters from darkness into light of
Islam. No, he's going to send you to hellfire.
I can't be more honest. Honesty is the best policy.
We want you to be honest.
We want you to be honest.
So what I'm saying to you, brother, Ibn Kathir is not inspired by God. He is right in many things. I could never even imagine to have any what his knowledge is. No way. I mean, I'm like a drop in the ocean to Ibn Kathir. Very knowledgeable human being, but yet a human being. And humans can make mistakes. The prophets don't. Prophets are inspired and helped by God.
Prophets don't make mistakes. Have you heard the hadith that Muhammad says the sun rises between the horns of Shaitan and it sets in a muddy spring of water? And that is confirmed in the Quran. So if you say prophets don't make mistakes,
and
that's
they
a
also
very
sin
massive
the Quran
mistake.
Well.
And that? Also the one of the shooting star. There's many mistakes.
Can I answer that? Okay.
So how does it rise between
Muhammad
the horns of
Shaitan? The same hadith, Abu Dhar, he narrate that hadith. The same hadith had three versions. One version says the sun set in the pool of murky water. There are other two versions as well. Do you know that? There another version says do you know where the sun sets? He said, Allah and His Messenger knows best. He said, sun goes under the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He did not mention anything about the pool of Turkey.
No, hadith. No, the hadith. I would like to ask you a question about the... Yes, I know the hadith.
But there's a conflicting hadith of the same story.
Thank you. So now he's showing there's more contradictions in the Islamic narrative. This is the problem with Islam. It's like the story of the Al-Isra and the Miraj story when it goes to Muhammad goes to heaven. There's a problem because some people say it's a spiritual journey, some people say it's a physical journey. So every story in the Quran has another side contradiction. And this is why we cannot accept Islam.
What it tells us, the hadith can be right and can be wrong. That meaning, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam never said that. That means he never said that. People are saying he said that. So how can he say two conflicting things? Meaning, the one who's narrating hadith, the collecting hadith, they make mistakes. That's why this kind of hadith, we do not take it as the authority.
So that can't apply to the hadith that Asahi.
But the challenge of the Quran is, Quran has no errors.
Oh, the Quran has many.
Give me one.
The sun sets and the money's full of water. Shooting stars and missiles to shoot shaitans. Which other one? Sperm in the backbone of a rib. No, that's in the tafsir.
Can we talk about the pool of water?
Oh, yeah, that's the nun.
I'm going in two minutes.
Yes.
Okay.
Abbas is going in 2 minutes. You're getting difficult questions.
No, because you see, Hatun came to me as well.
Hatun wanted me as well.
Look, you see the point I just said to him. Quran doesn't have any errors. Yeah.
Yes.
What proves my earlier point? That he said you agree with CP that Quran has contradictions. I'm still standing on it. Quran doesn't have any single contradiction, and I'm challenging it. He bring to me the verse in the Quran. The sun set in the pool of muddy water.
What does that mean?
Do you know what Allah is saying that? You didn't pay attention on that verse. Allah says, and he found sun setting in the pool of muddy water.
Yeah.
Allah is not saying sun was setting, but he said he found, meaning you find something easy, I find same thing.
Yeah, but the hadith
brother, let me. Look, we are putting hadith aside, now we're talking about the Quran.
No, it's the Quran and the hadith.
Because I just told you about hadith, there are two different words.
So does that mean that he...
Okay, look, you find something easy, I find something difficult. One minute. Meaning, this is talking about the perception.
Yeah.
Zulkarnain's perception was, he saw the sun setting.
That's what it looked like to him. That's right.
For example, that sun, if you see, the sun is setting behind the tree.
Mental gymnastics. We're not just naive. Sorry, Abbas, I'm not naive. One thing I'm not.
Look, that sun will be
behind the trees.
That sun will be setting behind the trees.
Hold on.
This is our perception.
Why did he clarify whether it's right or wrong? He didn't clarify whether it's right or wrong.
We don't clarify.
If you're saying that he just looked like that to Zulkarnain, the Quran hasn't clarified. Because
the hadith actually says it sits in a muddy pool of water.
Right, so that's what we're talking about.
So the hadith verifies the Quran.
Yeah.
We see sunrise.
I told you that hadith has two different questions.
We can't trust that hadith.
Are you aware of the message of salvation according to the Bible? How we as Christians will make it to heaven? Do you understand that narrative?
According to Jesus, it's different than according to Paul. It's different.
No.
There's no difference.
When the man came to Jesus,
God's grace.
How do I find salvation? He said, follow the commandments.
That is one example, but if you look at all of the rest of the scripture, that's one specific example that you pick out. It's like a weight of evidence. But the question is, why do you ignore it at the expense of everything else that Jesus did? Jesus spent a lot of time saying that he believes in me has eternal life. Jesus said that all the time. Always pointing to himself for eternal life and faith in him. Now, of course, that one incident is there, but what I'm asking is, why do you pick out, it's very selective. Why do you pick out that one for the rest and ignore all the rest?
Tell me where Jesus says that salvation is, I'll die on the cross for the sins of the world.
It's in St. John 10.
Read what he says.
St. John 10 and St. John 6.
Okay. I'm going to die for the sins of the world. And remember, I think in the Luke he says, he will come for salvation for some people.
I've not read the gospel before. Have you actually spent time reading the gospel in the light of it?
Yeah, I did.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I did. So show me where Jesus says.
When he finishes that verse, I'm going to let you go after Hattu. But one of the important things is that you have a cult following on SoCo. And I really like the guys there. They always comment, hey, God bless all of you.
Guys, I love you too.
Abbas loves you too. But you're under delusion. Abbas is pro-Islam. He is anti-Christian.
Absolutely. I'm going to bring you out of darkness into light, God willing.
He wants to take you out of light into darkness. Do not follow Abbas and do not be deceived by him. He doesn't want to hear about Christ. But you're a nice person, but I really hope that you spend time trying to read the gospel in the light.
Where is it now?
I do.
John 10:10.
Yeah, is it 10:10? No, that's not the one. When Jesus said, I'll give my life for life to the world. It's not 10:10.
No. I'm going to die for the sins of the world.
Yeah. No, it's
sins of the world, yeah.
No, it's not 10:10.
And do you know, can you tell me somewhere in the Old Testament as well? Same thing mentioned about the Old Testament as well. When is Jesus going to die for the sins of the world?
No, is there? No. We need St. John.
Psalm 22.
Somebody St. John or St. 6 or 8.
About the.
And this I'll give you.
My fingers are too cold.
Yeah, so am I.
Okay.
St. John 8. St. John 8. 10.
So, can I give you contradictions in the Bible?
I would not like to get into that now for one reason.
Can we next week talk about it? Next week and this is my challenge. We talk about the contradictions in the Bible and the Quran.
Okay.
This is my challenge.
Abbas, to be honest, this video was for you to present to your cult following on SoCo Film. They want you to come to Christ. There are people praying for you.
You say cult following?
No, you have a group of Christians that really want.
They're cult
people. When I say cult following, it's like they look at you and they're impressed by you.
Okay.
And they really want you to come to Christ. They think that you're a good guy. That Islam is not the right religion.
And I ask them, and I say, please pray for me, and I pray for you. And let's pray the true God save all of us. Whoever the true
amen.
God is.
Say yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Here we go. Stop all that nonsense. It is this verse. 8:6:51. I'm the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever.
And is it John,
bread,
yeah?
Yes. John's and the bread that 51. I will give
John
is
6,
my...
Yeah?
Yeah. 6:51. No, 6. Yeah, 6:51.
And he's saying that...
I'm the living bread which came down from heaven. If any man eat of this bread, this is just one, he shall live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh, which I will give for the life of the world. And there's also St. John 10, Mark 10:45 as well.
We're going to go over scripture.
As well. But there's many.
Talk about mistakes in the Bible, I've got 1,000 in the Quran.
Yeah. And I can one contradiction in the Quran. Only one contradiction.
Yeah, please.
A polytheist saved according to the Quran.
Polytheist saved?
Yeah. Are they saved according to the Quran or not?
Can you quote the verse? I'm not a half of the Quran, man. Come on. You quote the verse because then we see the whole verse for the context of the verse.
Yeah, okay. So who's saved according to the Quran? Is it just Muslims or can they be like polytheists? Christians as well.
Anyone who reject the truth is not safe. Anyone who reject the truth. But according to Quran, there's only one kind of a person who will never go to paradise. And as Quran says, chapter 4, verse 64, I believe.
It says the one who associates partners with Allah.
Yeah, Allah says, Allah can forgive any sin if he wills, but the sin of shirk he will never forgive. Meaning, the mushrik will never go to paradise. The rest, Allahu Alam, they can go.
So how come this verse where it says that Christians, polytheists,
yes, that's right,
and Sabians
as well, who worship the stars, for example, are also saved? So it's that
contradiction. Yeah, thank you. He just brought you to another contradiction.
Where's the verse?
It says that Christians, the Jews, and the Sabians will also go to heaven.
Is that Surah 19?
Can we read the verse?
That's Surah 3. Can we read the verse?
Because I don't remember.
So we clear, Abbas, have you got that one? St. John 6:51. Have you got it? Where Jesus said, I'll die for life and I will give my life to the life of the world.
Yeah,
so that's one. That's just one. I'll give you many more next week. But one is enough. You asked for one and I gave it.
No, but there's a contradiction.
What's the contradiction? He clearly said, I'll give my life.
Guy say, how to Jesus say? He said, follow the commandment, follow the law.
No, wait a minute. You did just ask me, what did Jesus say? I'll give him. No, but I'm saying to you again, Abbas, that's you plucked out one instance where a guy came to Jesus and Jesus said that to him. But you've ignored, you've done that at the expense of everything else that Jesus done, where he spent his time saying, he that believes in me has eternal life, I'll give my life.
I will look into that. Yeah. But look, I am not one of those Muslims who say that where Jesus says I'm God or worship.
Right,
you will never see me. You will never see me asking this question.
Which is why we're polite with you.
You know, because I know in Bible does claim that Jesus claimed to be God according to the Bible, and I'm going to say that. But my problem is not with that. Those. My problem is I cannot trust Bible as the word of God. Why? In Bible, I find errors. I find interpolations. I find fabrications. I find contradictions. So I cannot.
So
I cannot
what we would like
anything.
You to do is to bring those interpretations, interpolations, and those contradictions.
I can
do
that.
No. Let's
when
sit
we
down,
come back
let's,
next
yeah,
week.
Yeah, because,
on it, because this was actually.
No problem.
Sorry to interrupt.
Yeah, sure.
You. This was to show your character to your cult following on so-called films.
Yeah,
there you go.
One more. Why brother Jacob characterized? He loves me so much.
Just one more. Just one more, Abbas.
We're trying to get along.
I forgot my two horns at home.
Just one more, Abbas. Just one more. St. John, sorry, Mark 10:45. The Son of Man came not to be ministered unto, but to minister and give his life a ransom for many.
Christ died on the cross.
So what I'm saying is that one that you use is quite selective when you, because it's kind of way of evidencing to pluck out one and say what Jesus said, and it was contextual.
Well,
Jesus said this to use that as the basis.
Okay. There are many. Yeah. For example, one simple contradiction is Jesus says, when I give evidence of myself, my testimony is not true.
Yeah.
Another party says, but when I give evidence of myself, my testimony is true.
Absolutely.
So to me,
absolutely.
What kind of what kind of a God says my testimony is not true? God can never say that.
No, he didn't say that. He said, if I give. No. He was also appealing to the Old Testament where it said that you must bring three witnesses. That's what he was saying as well. Because he was appealing to the Old Testament saying that you bring, you know, to any occasion, you bring three witnesses. So he actually.
I'm trying to make the Muslim, but
it's a bit of a misquote. He actually said, if I give testimony. He said, if I give my own testimony alone, my testimony is not true. And not the exact quote, but the Father with my testimony makes it true. And he actually quotes the Old Testament. He talked about bringing forth three witnesses. That's the context in which you were saying it. That just me on my own. No.
And this is why next week we're going to cover this.
Yeah,
bro, with Brother Hudson. Any questions you want, we will give you the
context.
Answer.
Next week, we're going to talk about Bible and the Quran. I'm not saying only Bible.
We can focus.
Yeah.
We want to focus on the Bible.
My problem is the Bible cannot be trusted. Bible cannot be inspired word of God.
It can be trusted.
Okay, can you then put your... Can you then, for example, give a solid example of what you mean by contradiction? Because I've got a problem with Muslim definition.
Interpolation as well.
It simply means if Jesus said something over there and then he said something here, that's not contradiction. That's kind of vague. A contradiction is something that where two things can't be reconciled.
Yeah.
If they can't be reconciled, it's not just simply that Jesus said, I'm a father, one that said the father does something, I can't do it.
Don't use the lamb and
book. Yeah. The contradiction got to be inconsistent. If you can't reconcile,
why don't we do that? Brother Hudson, I'm going to bring my contradiction.
Right.
If they're going to be rubbish, rubbish.
Okay,
and camera
okay, can't.
You should think that I'll bring something rubbish.
Right.
So you rubbish it easily.
Okay, bring it forward.
So,
I'm not trying to stop you.
But also fabrications.
You're too honest to be a Muslim.
No, bring
you need,
it forward.
You need
bring
more
forward.
You
know why I'm honest? Because my Allah says in the Quran, be just.
But Allah said he's the greatest of
Muslims. Chapter 5, verse 8 says, be a witnesses of truth.
Yes.
Be just, even be against your enemies. So that's why I follow the Quran, and that's why I try to be honest.
Well, Allah made a big mistake though when he, in front of the whole world, made it look like Jesus died when he didn't. This is massive deception. God deceived Allah, deceived the whole planet by casting the appearance of Jesus
we
someone else.
It,
so Allah
we talk about
this intensely,
because you say that Allah is going to go deep and deep. Let's talk about Quran and Bible next week.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you
so bring your contradictions.
And if I prove Bible, everybody.
Well,
if I prove Bible wrong, you're gonna better practice Shahada, yeah?
Well, I'm gonna scrutinize all of your contradictions. We'll scrutinize and see what you
Okay, so let's just do a quick wrap up. This
is
yours. Well, you've seen we've tried to show the audience. hopefully he'll come to Christ. But as you can see from his own words, he's not really interested in Christianity. But he's going to try and show us contradictions in the Bible, and we're going to prove it with the Quran. But Brother Hudson, if you've got anything to say, do not be deceived by good character. We're saved by the grace of the Lord. That is what is our salvation. Anything else is not of God, it's Antichrist.
Just quickly, I'm hoping that next week he'll actually bring forward whatever evidence he brings, and we'll be able to scrutinize him, because context is very important. Because,
yes,
you know, just flinging stuff, because what the general understanding of contradiction means is that Jesus simply said A over there, and then he said B over there. That's not a contradiction. That's very basic, kind of rudimentary stuff. A contradiction got to be two things that can't be reconciled. So I'm hoping that he'll bring forward some stuff, and we'll actually examine them and look at some context.
Oh, certainly.
But you find what the thing is, always context. And I'm quite sure that what you bring forward will be able to identify scripture with scripture and make a comparison.
Yeah. Well,
and you'll quickly see, hopefully, and you'll quickly see that it's not a contradiction.
Unfortunately, yeah, for Abbas, and if you do watch this video before we do debate again, there's 1,000 contradictions in the Quran, and I do have them on my laptop. So we could spend hours going over the 1,000 contradictions. So before you say the Bible is not foolproof, tell me how Allah can make 1,000 mistakes in one book. God bless you also.
Thank you so much.